Hi, I'm Nick White with the Hutchinson Fire Department in Kansas, and this is our new 100-foot Ascendant mid-mount Pierce aerial. We decided to put it on an Enforcer chassis. We looked at the overall length. We liked what the Enforcer lengths were. It's one reason we went with Enforcer. Other thing here, we decided to go with Mars lights to help alert the public. It's going to be eye level and in the rearview mirror of them. That's why we went with two, both reds. Inside here, the cab. Ceiling lighting is a big issue for our department, so we went ahead and put a 72-inch Summit Wayland ceiling light, and then along with 45 and a 16. 45 is just to help with addresses, and the other two along here are for ceiling lighting, lighting up the scene. Inside the cab, we went with vinyl for the kind of the clean cab look, so we can just wipe down. Also with our lights, we have it all where we can control. The driver and the officer can turn on the lights from either side. So. Over here, we've got the pump panel. We went with the Akron Revolution. We like that for the accessibility of easy to turn and not knocking your knuckles into our T-handles. We like all manual valves. On this, we're pretty picky about our pump pressures. So we went with the Finland series gauges from Span, the most accurate fluid-filled gauges we could find on the market, with the Pump Boss 400 as our pressure governor. So we do get some cold weather in Kansas, and since we went fluid-filled gauges, we went ahead and put a gauge heater, and then on the bottom here, we got panels that slide in to help keep the pump cool from the wear and keep the dirty snowballs from getting up underneath there. So once again, all the lights can be turned on. Our scene lights from this panel here too, if the guy forgets, needs to go to the turntable or the pump panel. Compartmentation is pretty the same. This will be our OV compartment since we do run a truck. I know we got water in the tank, but we do truck operations, so this will be our OV compartment. On the back here is our ladders. We went with a 2535, 224s, and a straight stick 20, and then a double-sided roof ladder of 16 with roof hooks on both sides. 20 is new to us, but we really did a lot of time in our territories and seeing with our 2.5 stories to reach the second floor window, our 20 gives us a good angle for that. On the back, we picked our mascot with the buffalo. It's the state mascot too, along with this truck will be sitting at our new station that was built on the Kansas State Fairgrounds. So this is kind of representing the state and us all as one. So the reason we picked the buffalo to be the station mascot. Like I said, we made another 30-inch Summit ceiling light on the back too for ceiling lights with the low profile look. But up top we went with a 1800 gallon monitor, manual monitor for our purpose of scrubbing. We have for our commercial buildings, we like that we could get this bucket down within 20 feet of a building and be able to reach and scrub our commercial buildings. Gives us a lot of versatility with this and our rear mounted pump. Compartmentation is still pretty basic here. We're gonna get back, we'll measure our tools and fit our tools and shelving how we want it. We've kind of got already an idea of how we're gonna set it up when we get back, but we'll go ahead and bend our own aluminum and metal on these compartments. We moved our can, we're gonna put our 2.5 gallon can in here for our can compartment, so our OV or doorman can jump off and grab his can just for quicker deployments along with his tools. We added that. But inside, we added EMS compartments. We added this as a complete storage, so the gear, is the officer's gear is stored in that compartment and they're not breathing it when it's inside here. Then we went ahead and added up top compartments. This is where for our life vests and our bulletproof jackets to sit. This will be also for our EMS compartment. If we have to grab the EMS gear, we can. And then on the other side is strictly charging for all of our battery operated tools and radio batteries that we can keep them charging while we're on scene. This is 100 foot. We got 100 foot five fly section aerial ladder. Like I said, we were looking at our district and we really wanted to get down low and not take up as much road space as we can. So we went with the mid mount to save that length and room. So we really like that we can go 20 degrees off the side of the truck and not have to lean it to a side, but we still can do that if we need to. With our Mars lights, we went with red on the trucks and white on our engines. So the command can look down and know if the truck's coming, they'll see red Mars lights. If an engine's coming down, they'll see white Mars lights down the street. Thanks for watching. Thanks to the guys on the committee, that's six-man committee that put this together to help design this beautiful rig, along with Rick Mosier and Mark Meshack for guiding us through this too as well. So, thank you. Thanks, Pierce, for building a great product.